going to hear what God says.
That's my prayer.
Amen. Let us pray. Father God, it's once more again, we humble ourselves under your mighty hand and your all-seeing God.
Yes, Lord.
To say thank you once
more. Thank you, Lord.
Your grace and your mercy.
Yes, Lord.
Father God, thank you for another opportunity to be able to hear from heaven.
Mm-hmm.
We ask, Father God, as you speak to our heart,
speak, so Lord. Mind,
Father God, that you speak through your humble servant.
Yes,
Lord.
That your word goes forth in your power and in your authority.
Yes, Lord.
And with clarity, Father God. And then, Father God, we're asking, Father God, that you send out an understanding heart, Father God, that the word of God may be received on good ground. That we may not only be hearers of the word of God, but that we may be doers of the word of God. That in everything that is said and done, Father God, that it brings glory to your name. And let the church say, Amen.
Amen.
And amen. Just want to ask a question before we see what I hear what thus says the Lord. Y'all gonna talk back to me on this day.
Amen.
I like it when y'all listen to the video more, you can be talking back. Amen. I just want you all this if you can turn your Bibles to the book of Numbers, chapter 16. Amen. Yep. The book of Numbers.
Numbers 16.
They say it's that thing. You can go past 14 half the time. Right. Amen. Amen. That's Numbers 16th chapter. We'll give you a few moments. Get that? Amen. That's in your testament. Amen. Book of Numbers, chapter 16.
Amen.
And we're going to do a little bouncing around in this particular chapter. Amen.
Come on, bounce around.
That is the book of Numbers, chapter 16. Amen. When you get there, just say amen. I'm there.
Amen.
If you say, hold on, I need just one more second. You say, hold on. That is Book of Numbers, chapter 16. And we're going to start at verse 1.
Mm-hmm.
Amen. I'll tell you, we're going to read 1 to verse 3.
And all right.
We're going to do a little skipping on in this particular chapter. Amen. Chapter 16, the Book of Numbers, read. Now, Korah, the son of Izhar, the son of Kehath, the son of Levi, and Dathan, and Amram, the sons of Eliab, and On, the son of Hillel, sons of Reuben, took me.
Mm-hmm.
And they rose up before Moses with certain of the children of Israel, 250 princes of the assembly.
Mm-hmm.
Famous in the congregation, men of renown.
Mm-hmm.
Verse 3, and they gathered themselves together against Moses and against Aaron, and said unto them, ye take too much upon you, seeing all the congregation are holy, every one of them, and the Lord is among them. Wherefore, then, lift ye up yourselves above the congregation of the Lord.
Amen.
Amen. And if you can swing over to verse 12.
Amen.
Verse 12. Amen. Verse 12. Amen. 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 Verse 12 reads, and Moses sent to call Dathan and Abiram, the sons of Eliab, which said, we will not come up. It is a small thing that thou hast brought us up out of the land that flows with milk and honey, and to kill us in the wilderness. Amen. He's calling Egypt the land of milk and honey. Now, catch that, y'all. That thou makest thyself altogether a prince over us. Verse 14. Moreover, thou hast not brought us into a land that flows with milk and honey, for giving us an inheritance of fields and vineyards. Wilt thou put out the eyes of these men? We will not come up. Amen?
Amen. Amen.
I want you to go one more verse, right? Verse 31. Look at this, y'all. Look at this, y'all. All right, now. The Lord's response now. Mm-hmm. Lord, we got to respond to this now. Verse 31. And it came to pass, as he had made an end of speaking all these words, that the ground clave asunder that was under them, and the earth opened her mouth and swallowed them up, and the houses and all the men that pertained unto Korah and all their goods. They and all that pertained to them went down alive into the pit, and the earth closed upon among them, and they perished from among the congregation. And all Israel that were round about them fled at the cry of them, for they said, lest the earth swallow us up also. And they came out of fire from the Lord and consumed the 250 men that offered incense. And God's word is already blessed.
Amen.
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 You may be
saved
in the house of the Lord. Amen.
Amen.
Amen. The title of this particular message video entitled us under the series God's will. But the subtitle of this message is simply entitled, The Lord Will Fight for Those Who Are Trusting in Him.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
Let me say that. Somebody needs to be reminded on today. The Lord.
The Lord will.
Will fight for those.
Yes.
Who is trusting in Him. Amen. We got everybody trusting in God on today, y'all.
Amen. Amen.
For the last few weeks, the Holy Spirit of God has reminded us of how important it is for the believer to be found trusting in God's direction for one's life.
Mm-hmm.
Not only in this life, but in the life after. And one of the reasons why it is imperative for the believer to live life trusting that God is not only capable, but able to get us where he is leading is because when God is leading and guiding, those who are trusting in God's direction for one's life, there will be seasons in the believer's life in which God will allow one to encounter the spiritual battles of life.
Amen. Amen.
Can we talk to y'all?
All yes. Right.
Amen.
The reason why it's imperative that the believer is found trusting in God's direction for one's life is because there will be seasons in the believer's life when God will allow the believer to be confronted with the conflicts of life.
Right.
Oh, yes. Yes. Oh, yes.
Even when God is leading and guiding, somebody needs to understand that there will be times when God will allow the believer to be involved in some spiritual fisticuffs.
Right. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Somebody close to know what that means. Amen. Amen. Yeah. Amen. 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 And the reason why God allows these seasons to take place in the believer's life is, number one, is to strengthen the believer's faith in God through Christ Jesus.
That's right.
Are we talking to y'all on this morning?
Yeah. Yeah. Yeah.
The second reason why God allows the believer, that God allows you and I to go through seasons such as this, is simply to remind the believer that God will fight for those who are trusting in him.
Oh, yes.
Amen.
I've got to add this because of the times that we're living in, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Even in situations when one has to physically protect one's family, God will fight
indeed
through us.
That's right.
I'm talking to somebody on today.
Oh, yes. Oh, yeah.
Amen. Amen. And because of the times that we're living in today, it is important for the body of Christ to be reminded that according to Exodus, the 15th chapter, verse 3,
The Bible says that the Lord is a man of war.
Mm-hmm.
The
Amen.
Lord is his man.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Because of the church age that we're living in today, my brothers and sisters, it is important for the believer to be reminded that as Jehoshaphat reminded the people of God, that the battle is not yours, but it's God's. Can we talk to somebody else? Somebody needs to know today that the battle is not yours, but it is God. I think somebody can catch us today, so I got
Amen.
To say there. We simply come to remind someone on today that because we serve a God that specializes in the art of war. How many know that God specializes in the art of war?
Yes, he does.
Whatever battle that we're facing on today, how many know that God will fight for us every step of the way? Anybody fight some battle on today, y'all? You need to know that God is ready to fight for y'all. I don't know, Deaconess, but it looked like somebody don't believe me, y'all. It looked like somebody said, well, I really don't believe that God will fight by every way, y'all. That's all right, y'all. Because we brought a witness with us, y'all. And qualified that God fight for those who are trusting in him.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
It is on today, my brothers and sisters, we're simply like to qualify according to the word of God.
Okay.
That when the believer is trusting in God for one life, that God will fight for us
mm-hmm.
every step of the way.
Yes,
yeah.
He will. Amen.
And because how many know, my brothers and sisters, that if God is not fighting, then we're not winning.
Amen.
If God is not fighting, we're not winning, y'all.
Right,
so we just want to remind somebody else of that. When we're trusting in God, God will fight for us every step.
Amen.
Of the way.
Amen.
Are you with us on this morning,
yes.
y'all? The countdown count that we would dive into to qualify this truth is in the season of life of the children of Israel that is often overlooked.
Mm-hmm.
The way that we will qualify this truth is simply look at an account of the life of the children of Israel that is often overlooked by the church.
Mm-hmm.
Come on.
For the Bible says in Numbers, the 15th chapter, which is the previous chapter from which we just read. The Bible says that after this generation that was numbered from 20 years old and upward had gathered themselves against the Lord because of unbelief.
Mm-hmm.
By God's command, Moses had informed this generation that they will not enter into the land which God has swore to them, except Caleb and Joshua.
Amen.
Can we take our time and build this thing up, y'all?
Right.
The Bible lets us know that in the previous chapter, by God's command,
mm-hmm.
Moses had now informed this generation 20 years and upward that had rebelled against God's direction for their lives because of unbelief, that by God's command, Moses informed this generation that for the next 40 years,
well,
God, that they would wander in the wilderness until their carcasses wasted in the wilderness.
Right.
Are we in the word on this morning, y'all?
Amen.
We will also find in the previous chapter, right around verse 31, that this generation that was 20 years and upward had also been informed that the little ones, the ones who they said were a prey,
mm-hmm.
that God would bring them into the promised land. Mm-hmm. Y'all know the story, y'all. It was also in the previous chapter that God also informed this generation that even though their children would wander in the wilderness to bear their whoredoms, that it would be that generation
well,
that God would allow to enter into the land of milk and honey. Are y'all with me, y'all?
I'm with you,
if y'all with me, then y'all would have just saw what just happened right there. Y'all.
All right.
If you walking with me, you would have saw what happened. Let somebody say what happened. Pastor, I didn't see that, y'all.
What happened?
Watch this, y'all. Why? Because of what God had just informed this generation of.
Mm-hmm.
What had taken place, my brothers and sisters, is the wilderness, which was used as a place of instruction and preparation and leading the people of God into the land of milk and honey.
Yes.
Had now become a place of judgment.
Yes.
For this 20, the generation 20 years. And up, y'all. Did y'all see that, y'all? The wilderness, which was used as a place of instruction and preparation to bring the people into the promised land, has now become a place of judgment for this generation.
Yes.
20 years and up. Can we talk to somebody on today, my brothers and sisters? Every believer needs to understand that in this life, every believer will go through a wilderness experience.
That's right.
Everybody needs to be reminded that every believer will have an experience, a wilderness experience in this Christian walk. Y'all, somebody might be going through a wilderness experience right now. But we also must be reminded that is not God's desire for the believer to perish in the wilderness. Let me talk to somebody on today, y'all. For this generation, 20 years and upward, the wilderness had now become a place.
Well, yes. Now.
Because, my brothers and sisters, we have often overlooked the events that had taken place in this season of the children of Israel's life, in the time that they were wandering in the wilderness. Many may have assumed that this generation had accepted the fact that they were not going to make it into the promised land, because we have often overlooked this particular season of life, especially after this generation had learned the hard way. You remember the story, the Bible says that after God told them they were not going to get in, but then they woke up early in the morning, they tried to get in anyway, y'all. Many think that, watch this, y'all, that this generation simply would have taken it bucks and roots.
Yeah.
That they would have simply just moseying around 38 years until they perished in the wilderness. But can I remind you something?
Yes.
How many know, my brothers and sisters, that the spirit of unbelief loves comfort?
Watch out.
Yeah. Yeah. Amen. Amen.
Can I say that again? Wow. How many know, y'all, that the spirit of unbelief loves comfort?
Yes.
Why do you think certain folk keep in touch with you? Oh, my goodness. Why do you think certain folk keep calling you, y'all? We thought they sat around, y'all. They took their lumps and bumps and bruises. But how many know, my brothers and sisters, that the spirit of rebellion is always looking for recruits?
Yes, that's right.
Yes.
We got any recruits in the house, y'all? Mm-hmm. Why do you think certain folk always call and you and invite you, sir? Oh, my goodness, in the name of Jesus, y'all. Watch this. According to chapter 16, I think we got them, Sister Hayes. I think we got them.
All right.
Watch this, y'all. You got to catch what happened here, because you missed it if you play, y'all.
Okay.
Not long after this generation, 20 years and upwards, had just been informed that they would not enter into the promised land, the Bible says that this congregation, led by Korah and his company, along with 250 princesses, had now rose up against Moses and Aaron.
Well, now.
You got to see this. You got to see this, y'all. Watch that. I got to say it again from this side. Watch this, y'all. Not soon now, this generation has just got word that they would not make it into the wilderness. This generation, 20 years and upward, led by certain leaders in this congregation, had now tried to assume leadership over the people of God.
Yes, they did.
Oh, my. Ladies, I think you got that thing, y'all. But I think somebody to get in the back. So we got to say it this way, y'all. Okay. What's the show?
Take over spirit.
Not soon after. You said it right there, y'all. Not soon after this generation was told that the generation that was coming up as ill that y'all wasn't going to get in. But I'm going to make sure that generation is. The Bible lets us know, y'all, that they rose up and tried to push Moses and Aaron out of the pulpit. Right? Oh, watch out now. See, we thought that pushing people out of the pulpit just started when we came along. But they've been pushing people out of the pulpit way back in Moses' day. All right? That they rose up and they tried to push Moses and Aaron out of the pulpit. It's right there, y'all. Are we talking to somebody today, y'all? Right. Are y'all with this story? Now watch this, y'all. Now, here's the crazy thing about y'all. The very folk that it just provoked it, God, because of unbelief, now wants to assume leadership over God's people.
Eats it up.
Y'all see that, y'all? The very folk that just rejected God's direction for their lives is the very folk that now want to lead God's
people. Yes.
Yeah.
Y'all see what's happening right here, y'all? Can we talk to y'all? Can we talk to y'all about this, y'all?
Amen.
Don't stop talking, y'all.
Okay.
Now we understand that we're living in the church age.
Come on.
Where the church as a whole no longer regards the word of God when it comes to leadership in the church.
Oh, Lord.
That's right. Come on.
If you don't believe, you just look on TikTok, y'all. But we need to understand on today, my brothers and sisters, that it does not change the truth.
Mm-mm.
That according to the kingdom of God, it is not God's will to place folk in leadership just because they family members.
That's right.
Oh, watch out now. It does not change the truth, y'all. That is not God's will to place certain folk in leadership just because you like.
Right. Well, now.
Well,
or just because you like the way they look, y'all. It's not God's will, y'all, to play for their leadership just because they're your homies or your best. Y'all. You know how it is. That's my homie, so I got to give him a spot. That's my bestie. I got to look out for her, y'all. But they must be called by God to sit in the church. All right, are we talking to somebody over there?
Amen.
Oh, my goodness. I think we lost about one or two right there.
That's all right.
Now, to understand, my brothers and sisters, we almost finished this, y'all. To get the pitch of how they were now coming against Moses and Aaron, specifically Moses, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
I believe Aaron was just casualty of war, y'all.
That's right.
To understand how they were coming at Moses, how they were going to try to push Moses out of the pulpit, it's important for us to be reminded about what the Bible says about Moses.
Mm.
It's important. We got to build this
Come
up.
On now.
Watch this. According to Numbers, the 12th chapter, the Bible says that Moses was a very meek man.
Yes.
Of all the men of the earth.
Mm.
In other words, if you ran into Moses, you said, "Oh, Moses, well, you one of the humblest I've been in my life." That's what the Bible is about. Moses was a very meek man. He was a humble man in the sight of God. The Bible lets us know, according to Numbers, the 12th chapter, that God spoke to Moses mouth to mouth. The Bible says when it came to other prophets, he spoke to him through dreams and revelation.
Yeah.
But he made it personal with Moses. He said, "When my interpreter Moses, I'm going to speak mouth."
That's right.
Well, can you imagine that?
Come on now.
Y'all don't hear this, y'all. The Bible says, according to Hebrews 11 chapter, the Bible says that Moses was a man of faith.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Moses was trusting in him.
Right.
So God. Mm-hmm. That's what the Bible says.
Mm-hmm.
That's how God described Moses. Are we talking to somebody else today?
Yeah. Amen.
Now watch this. What we'll find, my brothers and sisters, is that the way that God saw Moses was contrary to the way they saw him.
My Lord.
Mm-hmm. Mm, y'all didn't catch that. The way that God saw Moses was contrary to the way this generation saw Moses.
Mm-hmm.
Watch this, y'all. Let me talk to the people today, y'all. When the believer is living for Christ, the way that God sees us will always be contrary to the way the world sees us.
Amen.
That's right.
I'm talking to somebody, y'all. You know how it is. You wonder how the world sees you. Well, you got to know, if you live in Christ, they'll never see you like the way God sees you.
Yeah. Wow.
Are we talking to somebody today, y'all?
Yes.
understanding that, my brothers and sisters, look at how they come at Moses, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Look at how they attack him, y'all.
Yes.
The Bible says they first attack Moses by accusing him that he take too much upon himself.
Yes.
Lord, you know how many folk tell you think you went to the past,
right?
You went too much.
Who you think you are,
right? Uh-oh. The Bible says that they now accuse Moses of lifting himself above all the congregation.
Mm. Yes.
You see, somebody is lying. Either God lied or they lied. God, because this ain't adding up. This ain't adding up, God. Listen to this, y'all. They now accuse Moses of living just like them.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, are y'all reading the story, y'all? Mm-hmm. The Bibles, they said, Moses, who you think you are?
Mm-hmm.
We just as holy as you are.
Mm-hmm.
Are y'all seeing this thing, y'all?
Mm-hmm.
They accuse Moses of lifting himself above everybody in that congregation, y'all.
Yes.
They say, Moses, you really think you better
mm-hmm.
than everybody else in this
congregation.
That's
what they said.
That's what they said right there, y'all. Y'all got that. Watch this up. But they won't finish it, Moses.
Right.
They say we need to pile it off.
Right.
We need to chop Moses down on this thing. So the Bible says in verse 12 and 14, that they now accuse Moses of leading them out into the wilderness.
Well,
just so they can get killed.
Yes.
They say, Moses, look, you leads out here. You just want us and you set us up to be get killed.
Amen.
They accuse Moses.
Well,
of not being able to take them into the promised.
Well,
they are coming at Moses, y'all. They attacking Moses, y'all. Now watch this, y'all. Watch this. Remember why they're coming after Moses. Remember why they're attacking Moses and Aaron, specifically Moses. Because they just received word that they're not getting in. And so they figure.
Yeah,
they
want
to take over.
That's right.
They figure they ain't gonna walk in victory, so they figure let me take over this country right now, y'all. In other words, if we ain't getting in,
nobody.
Now, look at how they're attacking Moses.
Look at.
They are now attacking his character. They are now attacking his leadership.
Mm-hmm.
My God. They are now attacking Moses' walk with God.
Mm-hmm.
How is this relevant to the church today, y'all?
Okay.
Watch this, y'all. Unfortunately, we are living in the church age in which many folks under persecution.
Yes.
When it comes to following God.
You're right.
Are we talking to somebody?
Mm-hmm.
When it comes to dealing with persecution, a whole lot of church before church just fall, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Watch this off. We're living in church age. When one's character is attacked, they lead the church.
Amen.
Yeah.
Amen.
Soon somebody calculates
the time. Mm-hmm.
We're living in church age. When one's ministry is called into question.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Then sit down and go.
That's right. Amen. Okay.
We're living in the time, my brothers and sisters, when one begins to ridicule one's walk with God.
Yes. Come on.
They start living like they never knew God.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Are we talking to somebody today?
Oh, yes. Come on now.
But here's what we must understand. For those who are trusting in God's direction for their lives, the reason why the enemy keeps attacking your character is because he knows that it's through your character that God gets the glory.
Yes.
That's
yes.
right.
Amen.
Oh my God. That's yes. it. Yes. Y'all. The reason why the world continues to mm-hmm. attack your integrity yes, and your character, because the enemy knows that God is the glory out of your
life. Hello.
That's right. Amen.
If you mm-hmm. don't believe me, go over there and ask Job about that thing, y'all.
Well,
somebody needs to hold on to today. The reason why the enemy keeps questioning your ministry is because he knows that if you keep functioning in your ministry, that somebody is going to get the look.
That's right. Right.
Can you. We talk to somebody yes. today, y'all? Yes. You got to hear it, y'all. The reason why he keep calling you every Sunday talking about, well, I got something to say about your ministry. Y'all not hearing me say, well, that's he just letting you know, watch this, y'all. Keep on doing it because somebody going to get delivered next Sunday.
Thank you, Lord.
Somebody needs to know the reason why the enemy keeps ridiculing your walk with God. Because he knows that if you keep walking with God, somebody's going to forget about who you're talking about God.
Yes.
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 Yes. So the next time somebody calls you, sound like the way you walk and say, that's all right, keep on watching. I'm going to keep on watching. Y'all got to hear me right. I'm going to keep on watching, y'all. Are we talking to somebody on today, y'all?
Amen.
We almost finished this thing, y'all. Watch this, y'all. Watch this, y'all. The Bible says in verse 14, the Bible says that Moses was wrong.
Come on.
Chairman McClendon. Moses was wrong.
That's right.
He was enraged.
That's right.
He was bold. He bold, y'all. Bible says, and you can't play. Because you know how we eat. When folk falsely accuse.
Right.
You know how we get when folk start questioning. You know how you get when folks start ridiculing about your walk with God. You ready to bounce, y'all.
That's right, ready to fight.
But watch this, y'all. But look at what Moses, first of all, did not do. We're going to look at what he didn't do, and look at what he did.
Right.
Yeah. This is what most Christians lose the battle right here.
Huh.
Watch this, y'all. The first thing that Moses did not do is Moses did not give up.
Mm-mm. No.
Or he did not give in.
Mm-mm.
Oh, y'all not hear me what I'm saying to y'all? He did not give up or he did not give in. Because if Moses would have given up or given in, that would have been a sign that he was not trusting in God for his life.
That's right.
Y'all not hear me what I'm saying? Moses did not go and hide and have a pity party for himself.
No.
Amen. Did I talk to somebody else? Y'all? Yes. Because if he went and had a pity party for himself, it would have been a sign that he was not trusting.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
Look at the second thing that Moses did not do, y'all.
Mm.
Moses was not buying what they were saying.
That's right. Amen. Amen.
Moses was not buying what they were selling. What do you mean, Pastor? In other words, Moses did not allow them to convince him that he was wrong. And they was right.
That's right, amen. He
didn't allow them to convince him. We requested in his mind that what they were saying, it was right. And what he was, and what God said about him, it was wrong, y'all. Can I go to the church over there?
Come on now.
My name is public camera. I just got to ask the question.
Come on, ask that question.
How is it that once we get saved, then all of a sudden, we believe everything that everybody tells us? Can I talk to somebody else? Yeah.
Come on now.
How is it that all of you say, now all of a sudden, every time somebody tells you something, it got to be true.
No.
Are we talking to somebody on today, y'all? You can't buy what everybody's selling all the time.
No.
You can't believe everybody every time somebody tells you something. Uh-huh. You got to go to God with that, y'all.
That's right.
That's right. Well, such and such told me, but someone.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all got that. Are we talking to somebody, y'all?
Yes.
But watch this, y'all. But look at what Moses did, though, y'all. After attacking his character, after attacking his integrity and his leadership and his walk with God, y'all, the Bible says that Moses took it to God in prayer.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
It is right there.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Mm-hmm.
Moses didn't get on Facebook.
Okay.
God cried and telling everybody, as hot as Moses was.
Mm-hmm.
See, we always use this is huge. Well, you know, I was just too mad. I couldn't think.
Mm-hmm.
Bible says Moses was heated, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
But Moses still had a mindset.
Yes.
To say, let me take this thing to God and pray.
Mm-hmm.
See, the question is, whenever we find ourselves in a spiritual conflict, what's the first thing we do?
Mm.
First thing we want to do is snap.
Mm-hmm.
Y'all know about that. First thing we want to do.
Mm-hmm.
But look at what Moses said. The Bible says that Moses took it to God in prayer. Now, Moses could have snapped.
Mm-hmm.
Moses could have gave him the peace of his mind.
Mm-hmm.
But you remember last time Moses snapped.
Right.
He got himself in trouble with
it. That's right. Mm-hmm.
That's y'all right. Not hearing me. That flesh may feel good when you snap.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. But you might be getting yourself in trouble with God. Y'all not hearing me what I'm saying, y'all. Are we talking to somebody on today, y'all?
Yeah.
We just help somebody right now. We just help somebody right now, man, because somebody wanted to stop this morning, y'all.
Yeah.
We said, hold on, y'all. Maybe it's a reason why I ain't stopping right here, y'all.
Right, amen.
Watch this, y'all. Now we got to understand why Moses was mindful enough to take this thing in prayer. As much as he wanted to snap, y'all. As much as he wanted to give them business, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Moses said, look, how important it is to take this thing to God in prayer.
Mm-hmm.
The reason why Moses took it to God in prayer is because, first of all, Moses was trusting in God for his life.
Yes.
Moses was trusting in God's direction for his life.
Yes.
Uh-huh.
Therefore, Moses sought God to get direction on how to handle this situation.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Mm-hmm. Can we talk to somebody? That'll be time right there, y'all. See, even in the midst of conflict.
Mm-hmm.
See, we think that we can handle it ourselves.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
But how do you know that in the midst of conflict, God still wants to fight that battle?
Yes.
Even when folk attack you, God still wants to fight that battle. Because he said, the battle's not ours, but it's his, y'all.
Yes.
Every conflict that we run into, guess what, y'all? God is sitting there waiting. I'm waiting for you. I'm going to show you how to handle this thing, y'all.
Mm-hmm.
Are we talking to somebody else? The reason why Moses went to God in prayer on this is because Moses had learned that he was not going to win this battle in his own strength.
Mm.
Oh, goodness. You say, well, wait, Pastor, they were just attacking. They were just talking about it. It was more than that, y'all.
Mm.
It was more than that. The reason why Moses took this thing to God in prayer is because Moses recognized that this was a spiritual
blessing.
Mm.
Yes.
Yes.
Moses recognized that this was not a physical battle,
right?
But this was a spiritual battle.
Mm-hmm.
And Moses knew, I can't win this thing in my own strength.
Yes.
The reason why Moses takes it to God in prayer, because Moses has been reminded that those who are trusting in God, God promised that he would fight for every battle, my brothers and sisters.
Yes.
Moses said, wait a minute. I ain't got to fight this fight. I got a God that's saved.
Well, now,
amen.
Y'all not hearing what I'm saying?
Yes. Oh, yes.
While everybody was stopping Moses, go get him, y'all. Moses said, I got a God.
That's right.
Well,
that's going to fight my
mm-hmm.
everybody. Are we talking to somebody
right.
today, y'all?
Yes.
Watch this, y'all. I got to talk to the church right here. The reason why many of God's people are not walking in the victory that's only found in Christ Jesus
mm-hmm.
is because too many are trying to fight a spiritual battle.
Well,
right, amen. Amen.
Physical way.
Yep.
Yes.
Right.
We'll never win that battle. The reason why so many of God's people are not walking in the victory that's in Christ Jesus because many just don't believe that the weapons of our warfare
they're not carnal. They're mighty.
But mighty God.
Mm-hmm.
Oh,
thank you, Lord.
Strong. We got somebody.
Yes,
y'all.
Yeah.
We got those every conflict that we run into, y'all. It ain't coming spiritual. Our weapons are spiritual, y'all.
Yes, yes.
I was talking to somebody today, y'all.
Yeah.
You can holler as much as you want to. You can curse as much as you want
that's
to.
That's right.
But after it's all done, you just have a sore throat.
That's
right.
I've been talking to somebody.
Yes.
The reason why so many of God's people are not walking in a victory that's only found in Christ Jesus because they are not convinced.
Mm-hmm.
They are not convinced
not quite sure.
That God promised
Amen.
That whose that those who are trusting in God for the life,
mm-hmm.
that not only will God fight every battle,
mm-hmm.
but that God will fight every step of the way.
Mm-hmm. Amen.
Amen. Y'all know why I mean folks the bits? Because we still hear that saying. Well, I know I'm saved, but I got to lay my religion down. I got to give them a piece of my mind. I can't let them have the last word.
That's right. Yeah.
Are we talking to somebody today, y'all?
Yes. Yes.
Look at this, y'all. Look at this, y'all. We almost finished this here. The Bible says, after Moses took it to God in prayer, how many know when you're trusting in God, God gonna show up every single time?
That's
y'all.
Right.
How many know when you're depending on God to fight your every battle, y'all? God will fight for y'all. Watch this, y'all. They were just talking about Moses, y'all.
Yeah.
They didn't touch Moses. They didn't touch Moses. They were still talking about Moses, y'all.
Well.
Moses said, I ain't got to fight this one, y'all. I ain't got to lose no sleep over this one, y'all. I got a God that's going to fight for me. Y'all see this thing, y'all? I ain't got to miss 3 minutes just because somebody attacked my character. I ain't got to lose no sleep just because somebody attacked my walk with God. I got a God.
Well, now.
That's it. If you trust in me, I'll fight for you every step of the way.
Every step.
So I just want you to be careful. You want to attack my character.
That's right.
You say, Pastor ain't saying nothing to me. I ain't got to say nothing to you. I'm going to still love you and smile at you, but you better know I just took it to God.
That's right. That's right. That's
and
right.
You ought to feel the same way when somebody attacked your character.
Yes, yes.
Are we talking to somebody over
yes.
there, y'all?
Yes.
The Bible says that after Moses took this thing to God in prayer, Moses got instructions now, y'all. Moses came back now. Bible says that we can paraphrase. Moses said to Korah and all his folk, he said, look at here. He looked at all y'all folk that came against me and my boy Aaron. Look at this one we want to. Meet us at the tabernacle tomorrow. In other words, he said, we want y'all to meet us at the church house.
Wow.
Just meet us at the church house. You know, that's why I say, if anybody want to catch me, meet me at the church house.
That's right.
If you want to find us, meet us at the church house on Sunday, y'all. We ready
right.
there. Y'all not hear me what I'm saying? Right. Y'all. Watch this, y'all, because it was at the tabernacle that God would show up.
Mm-hmm.
It's right there in the word, y'all. God says, y'all, every believer must understand. That's the show. That whatever ministry God has called you to,
yes.
God will equip you,
yes.
and God will qualify his calling in your life.
Yes, he will.
Y'all not hear me what I'm saying? So you ain't got to go around trying to convince folk.
Mm-hmm.
You, if God called you to a ministry, he would equip you and would qualify that ministry that you're calling
yes.
y'all.
That's right.
Right.
Yes.
Watch this, y'all. Another thing, y'all, let's begin to the same. When a believer is living for God, God will
always
have your back.
Amen. Yes, he
oh,
will.
Yes, amen.
It does not matter if everybody else run out on you.
Mm-hmm.
If your spouse run out on you.
Well.
If mama and daddy run out on you.
Well.
If your siblings run out on you, you still standing out.
Oh, well.
My God.
Hey.
Said he always be with me. Now, y'all not hear what I'm saying? Well, how many of you fight? If you let him, he'll fight every step of the way, y'all. Somebody still don't believe us, man. So we got to qualify them, y'all. Look at here, y'all. Verse 19, y'all. We almost told the Bible says that they all got.
Well.
Can I say
this?
Yes. They all gathered at the church house. They thought they was having for coming for another Sunday morning worship, but you know something about this happened tremendously is when the glory of the Lord show up.
That's right.
The Bible says that the glory of the Lord appeared. After the, see, that's when they should have known. When that glory showed up, they said, oh, God. Moses and went to God on us about that. When the glory showed up, they don't know. I got out of there right there, y'all. I said, no, we ain't winning this thing, y'all. No. Bible says that the glory of the Lord appeared unto all the congregation, y'all. Now, watch this, y'all. You're reading that scripture. That God was ready to take out that whole congregation.
That's right, take it out.
He was ready to take them all out. Because they were co-conspirators.
Yes.
See. You would have thought they would have been behind Moses.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, man. Them folk was riding behind those 250 princes. y'all hear what I'm saying, y'all? So here it is, Moses. Now here it is. They coming against Moses. But look at Moses.
Mm-hmm.
Bible says that Moses intercedes on their behalf.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Ain't Moses something else?
Mm-hmm.
Not if you be true for yourself. y'all come against me? God said, I'm about to take them out. God find me something. God find me something. Yeah, y'all got to get real sense, y'all.
That's too many.
Yeah, that's too many for me, bro. That's too many for me. And then I say, God, did you hear what they just said to me? They wanted to throw me out. Moses said, no, God, don't take them out. Look at God's grace.
Well,
I would say, okay, Lord. Okay, Moses. Mm-hmm. That's all I want you to do. He's telling people to get away from the tents of Goliath and all the boys. Mm-hmm. He says, tell them to get away from those wicked men. Mm-hmm. He told him, he said, Moses, I need you to warn him. He said, don't touch nothing of theirs. Mm-hmm. At least they be consumed.
That's right.
In vessels.
That's right.
Definitely.
God, he said, tell them real quick. Mm-hmm. Run as fast as you can from those wicked men.
That's right.
Why is that important, brothers? Okay.
Come on, tell it that.
The Bible says in 2 Corinthians 6:17, wherefore come out from all of them.
These are
great. And be ye separate.
That's right.
And touch not of them. The Bible says in Colossians 2:21, touch not.
Well, come on now.
You said that, whenever God commands the believer to get away from some folk, you better hurry up and go. Mm-hmm. Are we talking to somebody else? Mm-hmm. Whenever God commands you, I think you better start separating yourself.
That's right.
Well, now,
you better start separating yourself.
Yes.
From certain folk. Mm-hmm. How do I know how many times have God told you you need to separate yourself from certain folk? You said, I got this thing, God, and you found yourself caught up in their mess.
That's yes. So, right. Say that.
I'm not here to go
upset. I hear
you, Pastor. You're sitting up saying, man, this ain't even me, but I'm caught up in their mess. God said, I told you to separate yourself. God said, you need to get away from them right
that's
now.
That's right.
I'm about,
right.
To, fight. I'm about to fight a battle for myself with Moses, y'all. Look at here, y'all. He warned me, y'all. He warned me, y'all. So anybody that got caught up in, they couldn't blame God.
That's right.
Are we talking somebody? Mm-hmm. The Bible says in verse 31 that at the end of while Moses was speaking. Matter of fact, Moses couldn't even get out.
Watch out.
You know why? Because what Moses said, what Moses was saying, really didn't matter at this time.
No.
Because God started doing the talking now. Can I kind of talk to y'all? Whenever God wants to start doing the talking, we need to just
move in. That's right. Be quiet.
Whenever God wants you just. Because God can say it a whole lot better than we can, start,
that's
y'all.
Right,
the Bible says that the moon that Moses didn't even get the words out. The Bible says, watch this, y'all, that the earth opened up.
Well, now.
Right on in that same
moment. Can you imagine that? Can you imagine that, y'all? No. The Bible says that the earth, it just.
Wow.
Bible says, God, it swallowed among y'all.
No more.
Just disappear. Mm. Watch this, y'all. The Bible says that it swallowed them alive. Wow. Mm-hmm. Look at God, y'all. Won't God show up, y'all? Now here's the thing. When God show up and fight for us,
yes.
Don't turn around and say, God, stop. I'll be talking to somebody who said, Bible says that they went down in the pit and the earth closed upon them. Oh. And they just disappeared.
That's it.
From the congregation.
That's right.
They was just no more.
Mm-hmm.
Bible says the fire came and consumed
250
men. Just like that. Watch the show. Just because they wanted to go. The leadership of gospel.
Yes.
Now here it is, just because. One would have thought, after seeing the earth open up, and swallow 250 men.
Well,
one would have thought after you run, saying, I better get out of here before the earth swallowed me up, y'all. you would have thought that they would have convinced
that as far as for Moses, that God is going to fight his every battle. You the thought. See, when I realize that God is fighting somebody else's battle, I'm good. We cool. God bless y'all. Keep on moving, y'all. You the thought. When your heart is consumed with unbelief, when your heart is consumed with rebellion, look what the Bible says, y'all. Look at these folks, y'all. Now you understand why God, they didn't enter into the promised land, because God was just really justifying why he watch this, y'all. The Bible says after they saw the earth open up and swallow them folks up, the Bible says that this generation woke up the next morning. They got together and they came against Moses and Aaron.
Wow.
The Bible says that now they accuse Moses and Aaron of killing the people of God. It's right there in the word, y'all.
Yes.
But here's the thing, y'all. It does not matter how many battles that we get into. God promised that he will fight every single battle. It does not matter if we got a battle every day in our life. God said, if you trust in me, I'll fight every step of the way. The very next morning, y'all, guess what, y'all? Moses found himself in another battle. Isn't it funny, son? Just when you get over one battle, you find yourself facing another battle. But how many know the same God that fought that battle yesterday is the same God that will fight your battle today, y'all? How do we know, y'all? The Bible says, y'all, watch this, y'all. I don't even think Moses had the time to talk to God about it, y'all. Because God was already there, y'all. God was already there. The Bible says, y'all, that a plague went through that congregation. The Bible says 14,000. Snapped away again.
Amen.
Because they failed to understand that when a servant, when a child of God, is trusting in God. Y'all, you better be careful.
Come on.
Because God promised that God would fight that battle.
Yes.
For the child of God. Are we talking to somebody?
Yes.
And so it's on today, my brothers and sisters.
Wow.
Whatever battle,
my Lord,
that you may be facing on today, whatever battle you're dealing with in your life today, cross this show. It's God's will. It's God's way.
Yes.
God promised that if we're trusting in him, not only will God fight out of every battle, y'all, but watch this, y'all. God will fight every step of the way.
Yes.
Isn't that good news, my brothers?
Isn't that good news today, y'all?
So whatever you came in here burdened down with, y'all, whatever been troubling you all week long, y'all,
Jesus. Then
you need to say, wait a minute now. I've been going about this the wrong way.
Yes.
I need to follow what Moses did.
Amen.
I need to simply take it to God in prayer.
Yes.
Because God promised me that because I'm trusting in him, that he will fight my every battle. You ought to be able to give God a hand praise.
Yes. Yes.
trusting in God, God take one to let you know tonight, God got you covered.
Yes.
God got your back, y'all.
Yes.
Because it's in God's will, and it's God's word. Yes. And if it's in the word of God and it's God's will, then it shall come to pass for those who are trusting in God for their life. Do we have anybody trusting in God on today?
Amen.
If you trust in God, if you trust in God, you ought to be excited on today, y'all. Because,
all right.
Because I'm telling you, I know for sure that every soul in here is fighting something.
Mm-hmm.
Is dealing with something. We dealt with something all week long.
Mm-hmm.
You're right.
Mm-hmm.
And you've been sitting around, well, I'm going to fight this thing.
Mm-hmm.
God just spoke to you that, man,
I got to stop getting my blood pressure high.
Yeah.
Folk of all about what's going on. I'm just taking to God.
Mm-hmm.
That's right.
And just wait on God.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
To show up.
Y'all
not hearing what I'm saying.
Amen.
Y'all. Amen. Monique, say that deal. Monique,
do it.
Every single time.
Yes,
y'all.
Yes.
Yeah. Because if there's anybody that specializes in war,
God.
That's right.
Amen.
That research.
Amen.
Let us have a word of prayer. Father, God, once more again, we humble ourselves under your mighty hand and your awesome power. Say thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
And your mercy. Thank you, Father God, for reminding us that you are a God of God.
Yes.
And that you have promised us who's trusting in you through Christ Jesus. That, Father God, this battle is not ours.
It's
God's. You promised us, Father God, that you will fight our every battle, Father God. If we depend on you, if we trust in you with all of our hearts and our souls, as you showed up for your servant Moses, you promised that you would show up for us.
Yes.
In every spiritual battle, in every spiritual conflict, Father God, you promised that not only will you show up, that we will get the victory.
Mm-hmm.
That's all we found in Christ Jesus. Father God, we thank you once more.
Thank you, Lord.
We thank you once more for being God.
Thank you, Lord.
And God all by yourself.
Yes, Lord.
We ask that you touch every heart right now.
Yes,
every heart and every mind. That whatever we're going through, whatever someone's going through right now, remind them in the midnight hour that they have a God that promised that if we call on him, if we trust in him, that he will fight for us. That you get the glory.
Yes.
Thank you for my praise. And thank you for the honor.
Yes.
Let the church say, amen.
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 Amen. Amen. Amen. Amen. One more time.